Check over there. All clear. Anything over there? Clear!
Get to the main lobby. Oh, there's a thing over there.
Don't worry, I'll take a look.
Alright. At least we've got all that done and saved. Who's that man there? Seems like there was something over here. See, that was, and that thing,
that, Lord Zenu, protect me.
That part of the Dark Brotherhood quest right there is one of the minor aggravations that I had with Skyrim. Because you get captured when you go to sleep, and you can't, there's literally no way to get out of the building unless you kill one of the people. And it's just kind of, it's just kind of,
I can be your best friend, and you're your worst
go
enemy.
Go over there.
It's up to you.
No sign.
What happened?
Eyes open! I'm here. I got your back.
That is what I wanted to do. What I wanted to do in the quest was actually not kill any of the three hostages. Fight with Astrid and knock her out. Not necessarily kill her, but knock her out. And then steal the key and escape the area. Now, doing that, of course, would most likely turn the situation into one in which you've now got the Dark Brotherhood on your tail. But that would be kind of a fun situation to have, where you're doing quests in Skyrim, but at the same time you've always got to keep looking over your shoulder because you're not sure when the Dark Brotherhood's going to be coming after you.
Okay, we gotta strip this place.
But you can't do anything like that. The only thing you can do is kill one of the three hostages in order to.
I can't find him. Reporting in. Stay alert. I repeat, stay alert. Suspect is definitely close by.
I mean, you literally. It's just that's the only option you have is to kill the hostages in order to have Astrid get you out of the building. Just stuff like that makes me wish, you know, Bethesda would have done something to give more options on how to resolve problems. But, I mean, I don't know. I've never made any games, so I don't know. You know, I certainly don't know what the challenges are for making a game of that size.
Bald-headed white man, find him!
Find that bald-headed white man, y'all. Oh, really?
Alright, who did the shooting? Show yourself!
Facing the hounds. And that's not good.
Yeah, it's me. That guy's here, please advise. Okay, I will.
Under the Bridge, Part 1.
This is security. Surrender your arms now or suffer the consequences.
What was that, sir? Going to be coming through there.
What the fuck?
Get off your backsides, fellas. We got some kind of situation here.
Sorry, Pooch, but this has got to happen. S- serious? Alright. I guess it doesn't gotta happen. That's really stupid. Go, 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 go. Employee of the area.
Base.
Base, this ain't no accident. No, someone's back to us.
See him walking around that way. Good grief. That was close. He just started walking by and I didn't even see him. Of course he didn't see me either. Fortunately. Is there any way to get through? No, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to do the disguise. I don't want to wear that stupid thing. Take any bandit chief or NPC I don't like and have them executed by hitting them with a poison dagger given to me by the executioner quartermaster and take them to solitude to be executed. It also spawns random prisoners who are walked to the executioner by guards and then executed every day at 6. So it's fun if you're doing a townsperson RP or just want to see the do you get to the Cloud District off the guy get his head cut off. Yeah, I guess something needs to be done with that guy, definitely. What's his name? Nassam, I think it is. leads into the reception area. So did someone see me down there or what? So there's no... So we're at least that far. Yeah, Nazim. You've pickpocketed him, killed him, or just stole everything from his house? Oh, okay. Well, there goes. was that, stupid knuckle-headed nonsense.